Salutations, celestial sightseers. I'm David Fuller. Welcome to Eyes on the Sky. What's up this week? An M object, but this one was not one discovered by Charles Messier or his assistant, Pierre Machin. Yet, amazingly, it is one that has been seen and observed by humans for thousands of years. So which one is it? A little history, mythology, via astronomy theater may help. In 243 BC, Ptolemy Soter of Egypt left on a dangerous mission to avenge the death of his sister against the Assyrians. To ensure his safe return, his new bride, Berenice, offered to sacrifice her long blonde hair to Aphrodite. Upon his return, she cut her locks and left them at the temple, which were promptly stolen within a day. The court astronomer appeased the angry king by pointing out a cluster of stars in the sky, indicating Aphrodite was clearly pleased with the gift to have Zeus place the hair of Berenice among the stars. Under dark skies, this area looks like a hazy patch of sky within a constellation called, appropriately enough, Coma Berenice, meaning hair of Berenice. Unfortunately, most of us are not under dark skies, but we can see this patch of sky with simple binoculars, and it looks amazing! The trick is knowing how to find it, which may not be so simple given that the constellation's brightest stars are only fourth magnitude, invisible from most cities and suburbs. Looking between Arcturus to the east and Regulus along the ecliptic towards the south, Denebola, at the tail of Leo, is about halfway in between those two. Drawing a line up from there towards Alcaid, the end of the handle of the Big Dipper, or plow, move two full binocular fields of view, or about halfway between Denebola and Corcoroli, if you can see that one, and bam, there is this very open cluster known as the Coma Star Cluster, or Melotte 111. And now this week's Dark Sky Fact. Have you submitted observations for Globe at Night? This week, while looking for Melotte 111, check out Leo and submit how many stars you can see to Globe at Night. It's super quick and fun, even if it's cloudy. Please be sure to participate this week. So why Melotte 111? Philibert Jacques Melotte, about whom very little is known, found work at the Royal Observatory in England, working his way up and eventually taking careful photographs of the sky. He published a catalog of open star clusters in 1915, and this one was number 111 in his catalog, which had no Messier or NGC designation at the time, despite being cataloged by the astronomer Ptolemy in 138 AD as a nebula. Interestingly, it was not proven to be a true star cluster until 1938 by Robert Trumpler. Zooming in, we can see most stars in this direction are in fact part of this cluster. It is one of the closest ones to us at 280 light years, further than the Hyades but less than the Pleiades distance, and contains 40 or so stars 400 million years old, ranging from magnitudes 5 through 10, with half or more within easy grasp of binoculars. The cluster covers a very large area of sky, about 5 degrees, so telescopic viewing of the entire cluster is out of the question. Binoculars only here! Compare Melotte 111 to 577 light-years distant Messier 44, the Beehive Cluster, or Precepe, the other side of Leo in Cancer the Crab. I have Starhop instructions for that cluster at eyesonthesky.com. Jupiter scoots close to the open cluster NGC 1746, and Saturn is visible all night long, especially well-placed for observing 2 to 3 hours after sunset. That's all for this week. Keep your eyes on the sky and your outdoor lights aimed down so we can all see what's up. I'm David Fuller wishing you clear and dark skies.